Hello, guys. Sorry, my voice is a bit shaky. I want to talk about divine timing and vibrational alignment. Now, in my spiritual process, I've learned that the more I trust the process, the more I trust myself, the more I get into a zone where my thoughts and my feelings are being aligned, where my emotions are being in a place of comfort, in a place where I actually allow myself to feel, the more I can trust the process and the more I can attract circumstances, people, events that will actually match this vibration in order for me to actually be myself. Okay. So they talk about the state of no desire. Spiritual teachers talk about the state of no desire. And that is a beautiful thing. And they also say that the only suffering comes from the fact that we are attached to desire. Now, I'm not saying don't have desires, because desire is a beautiful thing. But the more that you can recognize yourself and see yourself completely in the present moment, okay, so see your external world and yourself as something complete in the present moment. Nothing to accomplish, nothing to do. At the same time, when you have these patterns, when you have this mindset inside of your own consciousness, when you are feeling complete with where you are right now, you can realize that you can actually be anything. You can actually do anything, okay? So I want to talk about divine timing. I realized that, yes, I have free will. At the same time, I am guided always to be something, and to actually create myself as this full, complete being, okay? So they say that in life, everything is happening with a purpose. And that purpose, the more that you recognize that you are living purposely here on the planet, the more you can allow yourself to actually integrate and be the version of yourself that you wanna be, okay? So for me, at least, it's about a mindset. A mindset where I actually trust life, a mindset where I actually trust my skills, a mindset where I actually love myself, okay? So it's like sometimes we get mad because we don't attract the reality that we want to attract. And you should realize that you are actually attracting whatever is being necessary in order for you to actually learn something from it. Okay, they talk about karma, but I realize that yes, karma may be a good, may be a real thing, but at the same time, you can raise your vibration in order to release these karmic patterns from your consciousness and actually attract a clear version of reality that will actually match your vibration. Okay, I'm sorry if words are too much for you. I think you should I put it in a more simple way? Everything is energy. Your emotions are energy, okay? And when you are feeling something, let's say when you are feeling a positive emotion, you are actually sending that into the universe, into your own reality, and you will actually attract a match to your vibration, okay? At the same time, a spiritual teacher said that you get what you put out. So that means that life is like a boomerang. Whatever you are sending out will actually come back at you as emotion, as mindset, as patterns, as thoughts, as anything, okay? At the same time, feel free to actually be complete in the present moment. Whenever you are feeling complete, whenever you are not being attached to anything, whenever you are not being attached to the fact that you don't actually have enough, now you can begin to see yourself as complete and actually realize that happiness is being found within yourself. Okay, so happiness is found within yourself. Yes, we all want success. We all want money. We all want love. At the same time, we must let go of the attachment that we don't have that, in order for us to step into a new state of consciousness where we can actually begin to create ourselves, to create and manifest the reality that we actually want, okay? So So I think it's also about focusing on feeling good. Because whenever you are feeling good, it's like you open the space of creativity, of being aligned with your, maybe your higher self, with being aligned with your true self, you know? So trusting divine timing is also letting go, let's say, of everything. Letting go of everything and really trusting the process. Trust every movement. And also someone said that there is no such thing as a small change, okay? So you are always changing. And the more that you change, you can realize that change is not actually a small thing. Whenever you are doing something new, you are increasing your vibration into something like a big change. So there is no such thing as a small change. So whenever you realize that you are actually changing, you can actually begin to realize that you are attracting new things, new circumstances, new events into your life that will actually give you the opportunity to expand emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, okay? So my main message is really making you guys realize that you actually don't need external things in order to be fulfilled. All you gotta do is be, because you are a human being. This is why you are called a human being. Because the main purpose of life is to enjoy being. Okay, so trust wherever you are right now. Trust wherever you are right now, because that is happening with a purpose. Wherever you are right now, you are actually on purpose. Someone said that you cannot be off purpose. Even if you feel that you are in the wrong place, in the wrong time, you are not. You are actually where you are supposed to be. And this, with this mindset that I'm actually where I'm supposed to be, I can let go of the pain of the past and even of the attachment of the future. And actually, I can live fully in the present moment and realize that I have all the tools necessary in order for me to actually expand myself and actually be an infinite being with infinite potential, okay? So also pure intentions, because there are intentions coming from the ego and there are intentions coming from the higher self. The ego may be focusing on the lack, on the fact that you are not where you are supposed to be, on the fact that you don't have enough, but the higher self has a wider perspective where he or she will actually let you know that whatever has happened so far has happened with a purpose, and now you are allowing yourself and you have the capability and the opportunity to be a new version of yourself. Okay, so guys, the main point of focus should be in the present moment. The main point of focus is the fact that you inside you have anything necessary in order for you to actually expand and grow as your true self. Okay, you are unique, you are beautiful, you are loved, and you have potential, and you have energy, and you can shift your mindset in order for you to actually create and help the world expand. Okay, guys, so divine timing, everything is happening with a purpose. Stop judging yourself, stop judging the past, stop judging the future, stop judging other people, and realize that when you shift your mindset, everything around you will shift, because the external world is only a reflection of your inner being, of your inner progress, of your inner love. Okay, so thank you for watching this live. Thank you for being with me on this journey. I'm in a place where I begin to let go and I actually take back my own power and actually allow myself to be myself, even though sometimes I get through hard moments, even though sometimes I'm out of alignment maybe, but I actually trust divine timing. I actually trust the fact that I'm being at the right moment, at the right time. Thank you for watching, guys, and see you on whatever is coming up next. I love you. Ciao.